Hello, hello, everybody. I'm Steve Reinharz, CEO and CTO of Artificial Intelligence Technology Solutions, hopefully your favorite ticker in the entire world. Thank you for watching. Thank you for being part of our journey. Thank you for liking, subscribing, and sharing. And I want to lead off by pointing you to the Wheel of AITX. Now, I don't know if we're going to really end up calling it that, but I was so proud and happy to be able to share everything that we've built. You know that we've sold almost everything that's on this chart. We've sold a RADDOG LE1. We diverted resources into RADDOG LE2, which we'll get to in a minute, and obviously ROAMEOs and so forth. So what an incredible lineup. I think it could only be done if you have a strong founder that can communicate a vision and build the devices, raise the teams, and find the customers for it. So very excited to share that with you. And quite frankly, I've been at the Rex for the last couple of days where I'm recording right now, of course. So I haven't looked online. I haven't looked at any feedback. I haven't looked at the stock. I don't know what's happening per se on that because we've got a lot going on right now. We just had our biggest customer in the Rex, here at the Rex, for the last 2 days. It's their third visit to come see us. And that was super, super, super fun. Okay, now, since I'm here, of course, I am in the presence of RADDOG LE2 as well as ROAMEO. I want to give you guys a quick tour of each of those products. Let's take a look. So this is your first time seeing me with RADDOG LE2, and you can see that it's got the wheels. And the wheels are so important for speed and mobility. This unit can climb chairs, climb through rubble, have incredible mobility. It has built-in obstacle avoidance that supplements manual control and teleoperations as well. Plus our screen, of course. Our screen is so important that when we're diffusing an incident, by having a human face talking to the person, number one, negotiators use their face to communicate and disarm different situations. It becomes a much more personal interaction, which leads to citizen safety. This is RADDOG 2LE. We'll be building it right here in the Rex, making it an American product because it is American guts, body, and brains. And of course, our beautiful, incredible ROAMEO Gen 4. You can see how tall it is. It's hitting almost 7 feet tall with the top LiDAR. Of course, there's many more LiDARs and sensors on this unit. We're using full-size wheels and tires. Each wheel and tire has its own propulsion system, but it is just front wheel steer. We've got this really cool, which was a surprise from our engineers when they got, you know, kind of vehicle quality, ROAMEO type letters on it. Isn't that cool? It's like very cool. I love that. I thought that was a super cool feature. On the front of the unit, these are turn signals. These are part of the headlight systems. This is a fully adjustable LED panel. So what we do on the bottom side is we're giving indications as to the path of travel for ROAMEO. We want the unit to be very simple to understand where it's going. This allows acceptance from people that are around it as opposed to rejection. If it's just some bot type thing wandering around, you don't know what it's doing. So this provides confidence and security. We got some adjustable headlights on the bottom as well. Looking great, right? Just such a great device. Now, this area on the front here, and there's a matching area on the back, is flex space. So this is for customers that say, hey, I like what you have on top, but I might want to put some thermal cameras. I want to put some RFID readers. I don't know what I want to do. But from our perspective, I don't want to have to redesign the thing or go through a big design process. So we have this flex space that makes it easy for us to make modifications. Let's take a look at it from this side now as you come across. And we've got on top what we call our turret. You know, back in the old ROAMEOs, it was more of a turret the way that it was designed, but it's still a turret. And you can tell we're using four panels, and here we just have some placeholder movies playing. But this, of course, is effectively ROSA technology. Four cameras, just like on top of a Rio 360, ROSA tandem on top, doing all those analytics and all that work that all of our devices do. Coming around a little bit, we got our
super slick white wall tires, which I love, speaker output, microphone input, and another screen on the side that's additional flex space. So right now, in the iteration that we have in front of us, we're talking about the route and some speed, you know, 2 meters per second, temperature, and so forth. This is what we have right now. But the customer is going to choose how they want this space to change, how they want that space to change again, adding to what a security guard would do on patrol, uplifting and providing additional value. There's a lot more features that we're going to share with you over the coming weeks and months. These two units are going to be at ISC West at the beginning of April, so you'll see some more media and probably some of our partners start to post about it as well. But folks, those are our two latest mobility solutions that are coming to market right now.
I got to tell you, the demand for ROAMEO and RADDOG LE2 feels really big. It feels really, really big. And the number of customers that are expressing interest in ROAMEO is increasing on a daily basis. We had one customer who is brought to us by one of our largest dealers, one of the largest dealers in the United States, and they were like, listen, we want to be first. What do we have to do to be the first for a ROAMEO deployment? And you know, when you're talking Fortune 500 companies and they're saying those things to you, it's like, oh my God, yes. Now, talking about Fortune 500 customers, the customer that was here these last couple of days that I just referred to was here and they pulled in. And what was happening? Well, ROAMEO was just running loops around the facility. And then what ROAMEO did is ROAMEO, we had a door forced alarm. Okay, so we kind of forced open one of our doors, which triggered Sarah to call an operator at the same time that Sarah called ROAMEO over to the location. Think about how that is something that didn't involve humans, so there was no risk, how it would definitely disarm and scare people off. So the solutions are coming together, and they're coming together right now. So it's very exciting for all of us. Upcoming, a lot of work is going into ISC West. So big booth. I will be sharing more information on that on subsequent calls. But for the time being, sorry about those interruptions. But for the time being, folks, I hope you enjoyed those ROAMEO and RADDOG videos. I've got to get back to work right now. Have a great week. Like, share, subscribe. Thank you, everybody.